Welcome everyone. I am Atze Bergsma from the Erasmus MC University Medical Center in Rotterdam, and I want to tell you about our recent publication in Human Mutation entitled Identification and Characterization of Aberrant GAA pre-mRNA splicing in Pompe disease using a generic approach. In our lab, we are working on research involving the process of splicing with a focus on Pompe disease. Like in Pompe disease, many monogenetic disorders can be caused by genetic variants which change native splicing. However, in diagnostics, these variants are often not functionally characterized and sometimes even missed. We hypothesized there should be a fast and easy method to assay aberrant splicing events using existing PCR techniques. Here we show that such an assay is feasible, is able to detect aberrant splicing event, and that it is time and cost effective. The method is implemented as follows.
The assay consists of two parts. In the first part here, you look at qualitative differences in splicing, which can be detected by flanking exon PCR. The products are separated on a gel, and when an aberrant splicing occurs, there will be an extra band which can be analyzed by sequencing. In the second part, we can quantify this aberrant splicing by qPCR using primers within each exon. By applying this method, you can detect whether there is a splicing variant, and then you can identify that. You can also quantify the extent of aberrant splicing, and you can correlate that with disease severity. We applied this method to patients with Pompe disease who had a partial or uncharacterized variant. Here you see a couple of those patients, and here are the variants. For example, we detect several aberrant splicing events, but also leaky wild-type splicing. Here we have a full intron 10 inclusion. We can also have a partial inclusion of intron 10, etc. So why is this method interesting? First, it is important for genetic counseling. So family members can be tested for the same variant. Second, the patient often wants to confirm the diagnosis on the DNA level. Third, it is important for future patients to know whether the splicing variant is pathogenic or not. And finally, one could predict disease severity by looking at the extent of aberrant splicing.
We invite you to test this approach on your gene of interest, and we hope you enjoy reading the article.